in today's program. Kyrgyz headdress a kalpak, how and what is it made of? Patchwork. Is it possible to create bright and modern things and home decoration using this technique? Jewelry craftsmanship of Azerbaijani artisans, their secrets and features. Kalpak, an ancient cap of Kyrgyz man. The convenience of its form has been tested for centuries. It protects both against rain and the scorching sun. Men wear it to work or during holidays. Honored guests as well as subjects of family celebrations receive this headdress as a gift. Every year on March 5th, Kyrgyzstan celebrates Kalpak Day. On that day, on the streets of the country, you can meet many men wearing this headdress. A kalpak is not so simple as it might seem at first glance. Previously, one glance at the headdress was enough to find out where Kyrgyz came from, how old he was, what his social and family status. Today, few people know about this amazing and for many lost language of kalpak. One of them is the designer Klara Asankulova. She says that over the centuries, they have been lost on how to properly wear a headdress. For example, children under 1 year of age do not wear kalpak, as it is believed that the felt has had certain magical properties that can harm the baby.
Кичинекей балдарга кара түс менен мындай тегилген калпактарды кийгизгенге болбойт да, анткени бул кара түстүн өзүнүн күчтүү сүрүү бар да, өзүнүн бир башкача белгиси бар, ошон үчүн бая.
Infants should not wear kalpak with black fringing, as this color has its character and magical features that are necessary for babies. Mainly, children wore a white cap with a green fringing. A pattern which symbolized just sprouted plant was stitched on the cap. For example, we sewed this kalpak at the request of parents. There are four patterns. A bone pattern inside the fruit, it's only a sprouting plant. It means love for the motherland, people, parents, and relatives. And this is a lamp, the same fidget, mischievous and playful, like a child. When a young man turned 24, the color of the fringing of the kalpak changed to blue. The pattern also changed. It stretched in two directions. This meant that the owner of Akalpak was already quite an adult and could protect his home. Or, for example, it was enough to look at the label of Akalpak to understand Kyrgyz is looking for a bride. In this case, he wore a kalpak with red or burgundy labels. When the man turned 36 years old, the edging on the headdress changed to brown, and at 48, to beige. It was clear to anyone they met. This man can set an example for the younger generations. Black color appeared on the kalpak of a man who crossed a 60-year milestone. If the widower decided to marry again, he put on a white cap with a fringe of black felt.
Бул түндүк оюсу бул эми жаңы үйлөнгөн балдарга деп ылайыктаганбыз да эми баягы адам 24 жаштан баягы 36 жашка чейин үй бүлө күтүп анан үй.
On this kalpak there is tunduk. It is the rim fastening the dome of the yurt.
Бул түндүктүн ошо баягы бир үй бүлөнүн ээси деп.
A person from 24 to 36 years old was waiting or wanted to start a family. When a man got married and became the owner of one tunduk, he wore a kalpak with a blue edging. Patterns mean that he became the head of one yurt, and the blue color means that all roads and all opportunities are open in front of him. This kalpak is worn by adult men, those who know the difference between white and black. That is, people who have seen a lot in life and can set an example for the younger generation. From ancient times, a kalpak was made of exclusively white felt. Since the Kyrgyz were engaged in cattle breeding all their lives, they themselves made felt from sheep's wool. Woolen fibers have an upper scaly layer, a cuticle due to which the fibers adhere to each other under the influence of hot water and steam. The principle of felting is based on this. Today in Kyrgyzstan, felt can be bought on any market. However, you need to learn how to distinguish natural from synthetic. Choosing felt, you can begin to carve out a future kalpak. It's pretty simple. Four expanding wedges. From the bottom, they are not stitched, which allows you to raise or lower the felts and decorate the top of the product with a brush. Every element is of great importance here.
Төрт тала болуп бычылат. Бычыларда калпак размери, ар бир калпактын өзүнүн размери менен бычылат.
The cut is made in four fields. Each kalpak is cut in size. First, on the finished natural felt, we will draw four sides. Now we are making a 56 size hood. We always use only real natural felt.
Жанагындай синтетикадан, андай мындайдан эч качан заказ албайбыз да, алып да көргөн эмеспиз. Синтетикалык материалдарды колдонгондо ал биринчиден бул табигый кийиз эмес да. Башты кысат, аба киргизбейт.
Баш оору жарат. We don't sew from synthetics. Synthetic felt will compress the head. It doesn't let air through, so headaches can occur. After finishing the cut, look which side is better. We make the smoothest side, the main side. In order for seamstresses not to mix up the details, we write the size of the future kalpak. Before embroidering patterns on the two front parts, we will make markings using a special template. On the front side, using the template, we draw patterns. This pattern is called a tunduk. You need to draw ornaments in an identical way. If we draw it in a disorderly manner, the cap will look messy and the patterns will be asymmetric. Previously, our ancestors did not have any patterns. Each needlewoman embroidered a pattern by eye and painted ornaments with a sole. I managed to see the work of my grandmother. She chalked up the pattern, then she put the second piece of felt to it and tapped a little. Thus, the pattern appeared on the other side. Today, patterns are embroidered using a sewing machine with thick stitching. One hank is enough for making five gaps. After embroidering the pattern, we will collect the kalpak. We tie the threads, cut off the excess. We make a stitch using a sewing machine, but don't touch the patterns. This is necessary so that the headgear was of high quality and no spools are formed. We sew in different ways. Sometimes we finish work in 2 hours, sometimes we can sit all day with one hat. We think that everything depends on the nature of the customer. If his temper is good, then it is sewn quickly and without problems. Sometimes it happens that some kalpaks have to be torn apart and done all over again. A maximum of 5 quality kalpaks can be sewn per day. Half of the work is done using a sewing machine and the other manually. All sides of the kalpak are joined with a velveteen tape. Its width is 2.5 centimeters and the length depends on the height of the future kalpak. The final touch. We sew fabric inside the cap to hide seams, then we sew on the label. We make tassel, which is on the top of the cap. By the way, it personalizes young generation and ancestors. We iron the cap, and it is ready. Kurak is a product that is created from scraps of fabric. It was sewn by our great-grandmothers. They believed that the ability to make kurak teaches a girl saving and accuracy, because practically any tissue residues are used. Kazakhs have a lot of different traditions. One of them is when you come to someone's house where an elder people live, an old woman will give you something as a gift, as a keepsake from her. Or they hold celebratory dinners dedicated to the 90th anniversary of our grandmothers. On this celebration, pieces of fabric are given to the guests. These fabrics were used for patchwork. Colorful patches decorated the interior. It is a merit of our grandmothers. For patchwork, it's necessary to choose the fabric according to color and type. Usually it is made of such fabric as velvet and velour. And nowadays, designers started using kurak in clothing and bags, where such fine and gentle fabrics are used, cotton, silk, and even more expensive fabric. It's very important to take into consideration colors and to be able to make the ornament. Traditional patterns are usually used for Kazakh national items. They are also suitable for kurak. Every ornament has its meaning. When young women get married, they move to other villages and other regions. When someone went to her native village from the village where the girl moved after marriage, she handed her parents a towel with an ornament. Her relatives could read from these patterns how their daughter lives. If we talk about the colors of patchwork, blue and light blue mean the sky and attract good luck. Red is fire, a symbol of life. Green is youth. White is the color of purity and chastity. Yellow is characteristic of wisdom and education. Therefore, as if the kurak says, life does not consist of only one color. It is saturated, it's different, it has all these components.
Бірінші, ортасын белгілеп аламыз. Бұл ең қарапайым құрақтың түрі. Мен 4 сантиметрден алдым.
First of all, we need to find the middle. It's the simplest type of kurak. I measured the middle on 4 centimeters. Other patches should also be 4 centimeters. I've chosen blue and black. We sew them from two sides. We take yellow and blue patches and sew them together. Next blue patch has the same length. We sew it to the next patch and so on. After this green patch, I chose yellow one, the length of which is the same as the previous one. We sew it from two sides. I take one more fabric and I measure it beforehand. The length of this patch will be the same as the length of the previous one. They gradually increase. When I sew them on both sides, they must fit to the sizes of the previous patches. First, we prepare square patches and we increase their numbers the same way. We sew them together. This is how we can make bigger items. Kurak mainly consists of geometric figures. We make it using geometric patterns. But the main thing is that all patches must have the same length. It makes kurak look beautiful. The length will change according to the patches. Geometrical figures that were meant by the craftswoman also have their meaning. For example, triangle, which is often used by craftswomen, means three forces of nature: water, soil, and air. It is considered that Kurak has a philosophic meaning. It is believed that Kurak brings prosperity to young family, keeps them together, and helps them to have many children. This is the main purpose of Kurak as a gift. Jewelry is a significant part of every woman's life. There are values not only that they are made of precious metal and stones, patterns, form also play an important role here. All this thanks to the hard work of jewelers who create real works of art. We will talk about how jewelry with national ornaments is made. Jeweler designer from Azerbaijan Eduard Shamaryaev devoted more than 20 years to this work, and during this time he made thousands of jewelry from a wide variety of metals and stones. I started working as a jeweler in 1996. I have studied jewelry in college. After graduating from the college, I was hired as a teacher of jewelry. My first works were made of copper. Once I have learned how to make jewelry of copper, I started working with silver. Then I started working with gold and other kinds of metal. Jewelers own a wide variety of techniques. Therefore, before proceeding to the manufacturing process itself, Eduard told us about some peculiarities. He himself uses shibike, or in other way, filigree. In Azerbaijan, this rather complex technique is inherent in various types of art in the same way as the use of national ornaments. But now we will give the floor to the master.
Работа начинается с выбора металла. В данный момент я делаю национальный браслет, азербайджанский национальный браслет.
Work begins with the choice of metal. At the moment, I'm making a national bracelet consisting of flowers. In Azerbaijani, it is called Gulgol Baga. It has 9 flowers made of 925 sterling silver. The inner filling of the element is called Vava. In Arabic, there is the letter Vav. It looks like a comma. And all the elements in this bracelet are made in this style. In its manufacturing, we have melted silver, pulled the wire of different diameters.
Стеночки делаются из более толстой проволоки, внутреннее заполнение делается из более тоненькой проволоки.
Because the flower consists of several floors. For example, these walls are made of thicker wire, the inner filling is made of a thinner wire. For example, now I ordered a necklace. It has 11 flowers of different diameters. Again, each product is unique in its own way and requires a special approach.
И требует особого подхода. Для начала изготовления изделия мы начинаем сплавлять металл. В данный момент это сплав серебра 925 пробы.
To make any piece of jewelry, we must first alloy the crowbar. Now it is 925 sterling silver. The melting point of silver is 960 degrees. Melting the metal takes about 2 to 3 minutes.
1063 градуса. Платина при температуре 1773 градуса.
Among precious metals, silver is the most fusible. For example, the melting point of gold is 1063 degrees.
Это самый дешевый металл из драгоценных металлов.
Palladium 1553 degrees. Platinum has 1775 degrees.
То изделие, которое будет по душе покупателю.
And if we look at the price among precious metals, silver is the most inexpensive. All this allows us to work using it with great return. The fact is that if such a bracelet is made of gold, then it will cost a lot. Well, after the metal cools down, we will begin to make a wire out of it.
The metal удлиняется. И вот сечение уменьшается. Ну, примерно вот так.
The metal lengthens and the cross section decreases, like this. Now we have to burn it. There is tension in the metal. It must be removed. The process of burning metal takes place at a temperature of 600 degrees. The metal cannot be overheated, otherwise irreversible processes will begin, and the metal will lose its mechanical resistance. This process is called metal tempering. There is also metal hardening. When we need to give frigidity, we heat it up and dip it in oil or cold water.
После нескольких раз пропускания в вальце заготовка уже становится достаточно длинной, и нам надо сделать из нее проволоку. До сих пор сечение этого металла было квадратным. Сейчас мы прожигаем металл и будем тянуть ее.
After passing it several times in the roller, the workpiece becomes long enough, and we need to make a wire out of it. Until now, the cross section of this metal has been square. Now we burn the metal, and we will pull it in the drawing board. But we need to lubricate the metal so that the wire drawing is easy enough. We use natural beeswax for this process. The metal is heated and lowered into the wax in hot form. After it cools down, we will drag it on the drawing board.
После того, как металл остынет, мы будем его волочить в волочильной доске. Этот инструмент называется волочильная доска.
The stool is called a drawing board. With it, we can pull the wire thinner than a human hair. The process is quite primitive, uncomplicated, something like this. Each time, the diameter of the wire decreases by 5 microns. Slowly, the wire passes from a square cross-section to a round wire. Every jeweler knows by heart his drawing board. Therefore, it's not necessary to check whether the diameter of the wire is correct.
Вот и получена проволока нужного нам диаметра.
The wire of the diameter we need is received. Now we will begin to make flower blanks, also quite in an old way. But again, you need to burn metal. To make such a flower, we pull the wire, flatten it a little.
Для изготовления вот такого цветочка мы пропустили проволоку, немного ее сплющили. И сейчас достаточно старым методом мы будем делать цветочки. В данном изделии...
And now using an old method we will make flowers. This product uses 8-petal flowers. With such a simple device, we twist the wire, we consider the number of petals. In general, a flower is used in many jewelry, not only in a bracelet. With it, we make earrings, rings, necklaces, and other jewelry. I'm twisting the draft and fitting the tip and count down 8 petals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And we have this kind of draft. And now we have to burn them again. Now we're starting to bend the flower and give it a shape.
Отсчитываю 8 лепестков. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Вот такая заготовочка получается. Поджимаю их. Опять же, сейчас я должен буду их прожечь. Теперь мы начинаем гнуть.
Slowly, a person who doesn't know much about jewelry will understand what we are doing.
Человеку, несведущему в ювелирном деле, становится ясно, что мы делаем.
While the flower is being made, the master says that white gold has recently become popular. This is the name of the alloy of gold, silver and palladium. White gold also has varieties. For example, it might consist of gold and nickel. Great demand traditionally falls on gold of 22 carats fine and 18 carats, but also sterling silver. But orders for products from platinum and palladium are the rarest. Sometimes it can take months to make one piece of jewelry, and sometimes half a day. According to the master, products with national Buddha patterns in the form of granite and fire are valued at the local market. Jewelers did not pass technical progress. They actively use 3D printers in their work. Products are printed in wax, in a special material, and then cast.
Сейчас мы напаиваем необходимые элементы для соединения браслета.
Now we're soldering on all necessary elements of the bracelet. Before that, it was a separate flower. And now we are soldering it on the special loops. Now we can finish the bracelet. As I said before, the number of flowers is 9. Again, it depends on the client. For thinner hand, we use 8 flowers. For bigger hand, we use 10 flowers.
На более худую руку идет 8 цветков, на более полную 10.
And finally, the bracelet is ready. Eduard says that during making process, he takes into account not only individual tastes, but also the cultural traditions of people. For example, if this bracelet was intended for tourists from Arab countries, the jeweler would have glided it. But in this form, the master short will appeal more to residents of the CIS and Europe.